Today, I'm going to take you on a journey of the five senses and share briefly with you how each of those five senses affects us physiologically and how it relates to the world of decorating. If you enjoy content like this, hit that subscribe button, ring that bell. You'll be notified each week when videos are uploaded. Hey, I'm Nancy of Designer Savvy. Welcome. Here's a fun fact. Did you know that if one of our senses is missing or fails, the other senses compensate? The first sense we're going to talk about is sight. It's considered to be the most important of the five senses, and we perceive up to 80% of all impressions by sight. Serotonin, which is a neurotransmitter, plays a role in mood, sleep, and how our brain processes what we see and gives us spatial awareness of objects around us, such as furniture in a room. Sense number two is hearing. It's a known fact that music boosts our immune function, something much needed, especially during these times. To dig even deeper, I'll link below in the description box the sources from this information on the five senses. Music is also known to help reduce chronic and post-operative pain, and it does this by releasing endorphins to counteract the pain. Music also relaxes their bodies by slowing our breathing and our heart rate. The third sense is touch. It's thought to be one of the first senses to develop. It gives us thermal awareness of knowing when something's hot or cold. Through our tactile experiences, we differentiate between pleasant versus unpleasant. What we think and feel is interpreted through our sense of touch. Therefore, psychology plays an important role in the sense of touch. A study done in 2010 suggests that the physical qualities of objects people touch, such as soft, hard, smooth, or rough, for example, affected people's judgments that tended to lean towards those same abstract qualities. In other words, what we touch directly correlates with what we think cognitively. Example is a firm handshake, which suggests strength in personality and character. Just as color affects our emotions and mood, so can our sense of smell. Our nose can detect about 1 trillion scents. And did you know that women have a better sense of smell than men? The sense of smell, that nerve is the only one that can regenerate, and they're renewed every 30 to 60 days. Scents that can elicit a response of motivation is lemon, eucalyptus, mint, and tangerine. Soothing and calming scents include vanilla, lavender, and hyacinth. Scents that are considered those that make a house a home include pumpkin, buttercream, and vanilla. Fun fact, it's believed that the sense of smell can trigger memory and emotion. Sense number five is taste. As we eat and drink, our tongue detects chemicals via taste receptors known as taste buds. Our brain actually perceives the flavors, such as sweet, salty, sour, or bitter. And as you know, different emotional responses are elicited as we experience these flavors. It's either a good and favorable response or unfavorable. As you can see how each of these five senses have a physiological impact on our bodies and with our emotions and our moods, then you'll know how to incorporate these five senses into the particular space that you are decorating. You get to choose which of these five senses you want to incorporate into your space so that it will elicit the mood and the emotional response that you're looking for, such as peaceful, calm, or energetic. To learn more about decorating your space and incorporating the five senses, you may want to click on the video linked above. Thanks for watching.